How do you know that you've got Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis and that your runny tummy isn't just from that dodgy kebab you had a few days ago? Well, stay put because I will tell you about all the warning signs that you need to know just in case you think you have inflammatory bowel disease. Hello, welcome back to my channel, the only place on here that is dedicated to providing you with the best tips, tricks, and information relating to Crohn's and colitis. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell to be notified every time I post a video every Sunday. So before we get started, it's important to say that if you are feeling unwell or having unusual symptoms, then speak to your doctor and don't ignore them, hoping that they will go away. Symptoms of Crohn's disease is also the same for ulcerative colitis, which is the other type of inflammatory bowel disease. And even though people with IBD will experience the same types of symptoms, they won't experience them in the same order or even the same severity, which can make getting a diagnosis a bit tricky. So, what are the signs and symptoms of Crohn's disease? Number one is pain. This is such a non-specific symptom as pretty much anything can cause a stomach pain and not just IBD. But if you experience stomach pain a little too often, which is relieved after you go to the loo, then it could be a sign. Number two is diarrhea. This is going to the loo more often than you are used to. Before my Crohn's, I used to go maybe twice a day, maximum three times a day. But as soon as I started experiencing symptoms, this went up to 10 or more times a day. Sometimes the abdominal pain can be accompanied with the diarrhea and can go after you've finished using the bathroom. So just watch out for this symptom. Number three, and sticking with the bathroom, is bloody stools. If you see blood in your stools after a bowel motion, do not ignore it. This could be a sign of Crohn's disease, or it could be something much more serious. And so if you do find blood is in your stools, which can be accompanied with pus or mucus, do not ignore it. Go immediately to the doctor and tell them. Number four is loss of appetite and weight loss. These two are usually linked because if you don't feel like eating, then you don't eat much, and that usually results in weight loss. What you may find with weight loss as well is that it may not be because of a loss of appetite. In my case, I associated food with pain because I would end up in excruciating pain a few hours after I've eaten something. And so the only way to not be in pain was to not eat, which wasn't a good idea because the weight loss was drastic. So in some cases, people can associate pain with food and start not eating because of that and not necessarily because of a loss of appetite. Number five is anemia. This is also a sign of Crohn's disease, which is also linked to points number three and four. If you are bleeding a lot after each bowel motion, in combination with not eating properly and getting enough nutrients, then the iron stores in your body are going to become low and depleted, and you will develop something called iron deficiency anemia, which is very common in Crohn's disease. This can lead to you feeling extremely tired all the time, very fatigued, and just generally rubbish. Number six is fatigue. So fatigue is very difficult to explain because it is not the same as being tired, and it doesn't go away after a good night's sleep. It's very unpredictable, and every point I have previously mentioned can contribute to fatigue and tiredness. If you're constantly in pain, then that's going to interrupt your sleep, as does going to the loo multiple times, as does not eating properly and getting the right nutrients, as does losing a lot of blood. So all of those things can contribute to fatigue. Now you know about the signs and symptoms of Crohn's and colitis, but how do these symptoms actually occur? Well, I spoke about this in the video I've done about my Crohn's disease story, and it looks like this, and you can find a link to that in the description box below. Also, if you want to join an exclusive community of people who receive my personal tips and tricks on living with Crohn's and colitis, make sure you subscribe to my newsletter, and you can find a link to that in the description box below. Now make sure you check out these videos on more useful tips, tricks, and information relating to Crohn's and colitis. Hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video, as well as leaving a like and a comment if you enjoyed this and found it useful. And I can't wait to see you all next time.